It can move forward as many spaces as is allowed. It's not able to go through pieces, but it does capture pieces forward, as does every other piece in this game. They all capture the same way that they move. So, it goes over here. Next piece. This one. exception of your cocoon, and there's another piece that I'll talk about in the description. This one is called the Isha. It means flying chariot. Isha. This one is to fly. Let's see. I think it's used in the verb dobu, which means like soar. Song by the band Track On, but I like, and the song is called like Tobe, which means fly or soar. And like throughout the whole song, it's basically talking about, I think, like not letting things like drag you down, just to keep going on. I don't fully understand the song, but I think that's what it's talking about. You only get one kakuyo, which is like a bishop, and only one isha, which is like a rook. It moves essentially just like a rook. Later on, there'll be some exceptions that I'll tell you about, but I'll get to that when it's necessary. So, yeah, this is the kinsho. It means the cold general. Typically used for defense because it has more space. this is what the Shogi board would look like with all the pieces on it. So, I'll just do some random moves. And I guess we'll give it kind of a visual of how the game would go. So, typically, whenever games opened up, somebody will, generally players will either move the foot soldier or the pieces can be dropped back on the board in Shogi. People are more willing to lose and sacrifice pieces. So, it's a dynamic of Shogi that makes the game a lot more different. So, another thing, one rule when it comes to drops. So, say one of these people gets captured, they cannot be placed right in front of the great general. That's illegal. Something else that can be done is, this will lead into something else, but pieces can be promoted. Once you get to this third line, right where all these people are, once one of your pieces gets there, you can turn it over if you want and promote it. When a piece is promoted, it gains new abilities. When a people is promoted, it moves like the gold general, the Kinjo. About almost all the pieces, when they are promoted, like the gold general. The only exceptions are the Kakukyo and the Hishan. These two pieces, once they are promoted, they keep their abilities, but they also gain the ability to move one space in any direction around them. They can do either one. So that makes those pieces very dangerous when they are promoted. The most dangerous being this one. The Isha is considered the most powerful piece in the game, and it can be pretty devastating if you ever lose it. So you have to think very carefully about what you do when you use it. Same column as another unpromoted Rufiol from your side. If your opponent had one in that column and you didn't, then it's perfectly okay. But when you have your own in the column, you cannot place another. It has to be promoted. And the rule is, if you capture a promoted piece, it has to be de-promoted. Or is unpromoted, I'm not really sure. So you can't place a promoted piece on the board. They always get placed back on the board and promoted. Oh. single piece except for the gold general, and the great general can be promoted. And what else can I talk about? What promotion? That's about all that there is when it comes to promotion. This is like totally illegible to me. I don't have the slightest idea of what in the world it is trying to represent. But regardless, it's the Nari Kyo, which means the golden Kyoma Kyosha. Oh, not really. Nari in Japanese, when a piece is promoted, the verb that's used for is called naru, which literally is like to become. So nari kyo means like promoted kyosha, not golden kyosha. Sorry about that. The game, if any of you ever watch the anime, the world god only knows, the main character is called Kama. it's split up into two. You have your defending army, and you have your offensive army. Your defensive army are the pieces that you use to build what is called a castle. What the castle does is the castle surrounds the great general, because you don't ever want to leave your great general right here. This is one of the worst places you could ever leave your great general. Generally, move your great general to the left or to the right, and then you have a castle built around it. And other pieces, which will generally include either both of your silver generals or just one of them, will move on to attack the opposing great general. So just for reference, I'm going to build a simple castle. So you know what it looks like. I'm trying to remember the name of this castle, but it escapes me. And basically what this castle looks like is... considered to be one of the best defensive castles that there are. The biggest problem with this castle, though, is that the minute that your opponent gets their isha, this piece, over here, your castle's basically messed up. I mean, doomed. Because it's not very good at defending itself from the side, only from the front. And even from the front, because this castle is so common, there is a counter specifically for this castle. Your opponent would basically have to go on the offensive to do this, and they wouldn't have as many pieces to develop a castle. But it would basically take down this castle by the mid-game.